डाउट्स में अटकते,
सब्जेक्ट्स में लटकते, कब तक हम रहेंगे सर पटकते।
अब वेदांत देगा प्रॉब्लम से छुटकारा।
हाय किड,
समझ आएगा तो मजा आएगा तो समझ आएगा।
बढ़िया टीचर्स प्रॉब्लम्स चुटकी में सुलझाएंगे,
डाउट सारी जिंदगी से।
Raj, I got your doubt. This is your answer.
समझ आएगा तो मजा आएगा।
वेदांतु, लर्न लाइव ऑनलाइन। टू अटेंड अ फ्री लाइव क्लास, डाउनलोड द ऐप नाउ।
Hey guys, this is Ambika, Master Teacher of Biology at Vedantu. We often wonder how toppers make their timetable, right? When we hear their success stories, that's very often the first question, one of the first questions that pops up in our heads as to how they make their timetables. So in today's video, I would like to give you a timetable, or rather give you additional tips on how to make your timetable so that you can also become a topper. Okay, so in fact, in my personal opinion, I would like to rephrase that question a little bit. If the question is, how do toppers make their timetable? I would put it this way. How to make a timetable so that I can become a topper. Okay, so let's get started. What are the things that you need to keep in mind as a student, maybe a month or probably 2 months before your very, very important exam? Okay, so you need time for sleep. Of course, very important to give you energy, to make you feel refreshed and ready for the next day, right? So time for sleep, time to eat a well-balanced, nutritious diet and not any fast food or junk food. So time to sleep, time to eat, time to exercise, of course, time to study. And most certainly, you also need to squeeze in, not exactly squeeze in, I would say, give importance to some time wherein you can just sit down, relax, chill, talk with your friends, talk with your family, and whatever else will help you refresh your brain and rejuvenate yourself and get back to your next study session. Okay, so I have in fact made a timetable for you, but please note that there are no hard and fast rules for this, okay? You are free to alter it, change it according to your strengths, according to your weaknesses, but just in case you have no clue on how and where to get started, this is for you. And in that case, stay with me until the very end. Okay, so in my timetable, your day starts at 5 a.m. Okay, 5 in the morning, you wake up. And what do you do first thing after you wake up? It's important to stretch out completely so that blood is pumped across your body, and that will really make you feel much more refreshed and energized. Okay, so stretch out first. Of course, go and do all your morning chores, attend nature's call. All of that is important. And at the same time, it's important to have something refreshing. What I mean is, whatever will give you a little bit of energy to face the rest of the day, like a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, a cup of warm lime water, or in my opinion, even warm tulsi water, wherein you soak a few tulsi leaves in water, in a glass of water the previous night. And if you can drink this first thing in the morning, along with chewing up those leaves, nothing better than that. Because I have tried and tested this method when I was in college. One of my botany teachers told us this, and I have tried this, and it greatly boosted my immunity. And I would say the time when I was having that regularly every day were probably my healthiest days ever in life. So if you have a tulsi plant at home, please do make use of that in such a manner. And also probably soaked almonds, almonds soaked in water overnight. This is probably the time where you can pick them up, peel them and eat them, or a handful of dry fruits, any other dry fruit that you like, so that all the natural fiber and sugar in all of these items can give your brain a good boost to get your day started. Okay, so I'm giving you about 30 minutes for all these activities. 5:30 to 7:30, okay, 5:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. will be your very first study session. So in my opinion, if you are a morning person, choose this study slot to learn to study your hardest subject, because your brain is supposedly sharpest at its function around this time. Okay, so 5:30 to 7:30, study session 1. After that, okay, of course, in between 5:30 and 7:30, make sure you take about 5 minute breaks if you go by the Pomodoro technique every 25 to 30 minutes or so. And of course, at the end of the 2 hour study session, around 7:30, go ahead and take about an hour and a half's break. Why is that important? Let me tell you that now, because this is the time when you need to have a refreshing shower, you need to have a very, very nutritious breakfast, and you need to get some good exercise. If possible, okay, squeeze in some time to get some natural sunshine. Whenever the sun rises in your city, if it's going to be 6 a.m., 6:30 a.m., 7, 7:30, whatever it is, early morning sun or a few minutes within sunrise is the ideal time for you to get some vitamin D in your body so that your calcium metabolism also functions optimally within your system. Okay, so in between 7:30 and 9, make sure you get some good stretching or proper exercise. Eat a high protein breakfast because that's going to keep you energized for the rest of the day. And then, of course, find some time for a refreshing shower and get some relaxation or whatever it is that you need to sit down for your next study session. Okay, and after this, from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., sit down and revise whatever you have studied in study session one. And after this, okay, listen very carefully, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., I'm giving you 3 hours to do a mock paper. Now, this may vary from class to class, grade to grade, or from what board you are studying in, because ICSE exams generally are about 2 hours in duration, and CBSE is about 3 hours in duration. Okay, so depending on that, depending on what exam you're going to be appearing for, I would suggest if your exam is going to be from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. during your actual exam days, okay, make sure you practice your mock test at that time itself, keeping a timer and actually getting the feel of it. Because every day practicing this is actually going to get your brain and your body into the mood of the exam. And just in case your exam is going to be from 9 to 11 or 9:30 to 11:30 or 9 to 12, whatever, make sure you plan this mock test session in your study sessions accordingly, okay? According to my timetable, this is going to be 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., okay? Now, what next? This is probably the time when you are ready for lunch. So 1 to 1:30 can be your lunch break. Have a very well-balanced, a very, very highly nutritious lunch. Make sure whatever your mom prepares, preferably homemade, rotis, sabzi, anything, green vegetables, dahi if possible, curd or yogurt as we call it. If you can include all of this in your diet, it would be great. And after 1:30, take a 20-minute power nap. But make sure you time yourself and do not feel tempted to take it more than that. Because once you have eaten a very heavy lunch, it's natural for the human brain to drift off to sleep. So make sure you don't do that because that can lead to negative results. Okay, so 20 minutes of power nap. And now we are at 1:50 p.m. Now, 1:50 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. will be the time that you have to use to mark your mock test, okay? Take up the solutions, the answer key. Make sure you check it and mark yourself and analyze where you have gone wrong and what topics you need to revise harder and revise better in order to score better for your final exam. And after that, 2:30 to 4:30 will be your next proper study session. But the only negative thing about this study session, the tricky thing about the study session, is that 2:30 to 4:30 is probably the time when you may be feeling very, very drowsy. So I would suggest pick up a subject that you would certainly apply your thoughts on, your brains on, like mathematics. If I were in a student's place, I would have picked up mathematics at this time so that I have to keep working out problems constantly and my brain is not allowed to drift into a sleep mode. Okay, so even if it's not math, whatever you want to study, a different subject for sure as compared to what you did in the morning. And make sure you keep taking notes actively to prevent yourself from going to sleep. Okay, and now after 4:30 until 5:15 p.m., I'm going to be giving you a 45 minutes tea break. It's not just for tea, of course, to have some healthy snack and to take a walk to catch up with your friends, of course, not for very long, and to chat with your family, whatever you want to do, but not for more than 45 minutes. Okay, if possible, you can also get out, take a brisk walk and come back. 5:15 to 7:30 p.m. will be your next study session. And in this time, of course, like I said previously, make sure you include a few small 5-minute breaks as and when required. Okay, again, a different subject from the previous study sessions. And 7:30 to 8 will be your dinner break. Preferably do not eat a very, very heavy dinner. It's ideally that should be the case for your body, for your mind, everything. Okay, because your brain will drift off to sleep if you have a very heavy dinner very soon. Now, after 7:30, you can take an hour's dinner break, 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. Again, a nutritious but relatively lighter dinner, I would suggest, so that your brain keeps functioning optimally. Always for human beings, it's not advisable to have a very heavy dinner, okay? And after 8:30, 8:30 to 10 can be your last study session of the day. But again, I would like to tell you something. 8:30 to 9:30 can be a proper study session. And you can use the last 30 minutes, 9:30 to 10 p.m. to revise, just glance through all that you have studied the entire day. Okay, not re-study it, but just quickly glance through it so that when you go back to bed after 10 p.m., your brain keeps processing this information and the memory remains fresh in your mind again the next day. Okay, so this is how I have planned your day, and 10 to 5, of course, will be your sleep time. 7 hours is what I have planned for you. According to this, you will be studying for about 12 and a half hours in a day. It might sound like a lot, but try this out, keeping away all the distractions. But a few notes that I want to add here is that it's not the number of hours. It's certainly smart study that always matters. So do go ahead and watch my video on smart study techniques if you have not watched it yet. And again, another variation that you can add is what I have told you, the time for your mock test. And just in case you want to alter this for your school days, feel free to do that. But this is basically certainly going to give you an idea about how to set your timetable to prepare for an exam. If you have any thoughts or any feedback on this, do feel free to drop a comment in the comment section below. And until we meet again, this is Ambika signing off. Bye-bye.